Did you know, sir, you're wasting $3,600 a year? You have a big problem, sir. You're wasting a lot of money on that FHA mortgage you have. My name's Claude Diamond. I'm here to save you. I'm here to show you how to save a little bit of money. I have a couple solutions for you. Boom. Something different. Or if somebody called you up, say, hi, Mr. Dennis, I'm your next door neighbor, Claude. I'm one of your neighbors, Claude Diamond. Your sprinkler system's on. You're going to treat me different if you think I know you or I'm in proximity to your world or there's some previous established relationship. You'll be real nice to me. Okay. So if I call you up like I'm a stranger interrupting your day, your dinner, like all those other phone calls, to me, it's back to that definition of insanity. Why keep doing something that you're going to get 100% rejection on for the most part? So the whole point of a pattern interrupt is just to get your foot in the door, initiate a good conversation with somebody. When I go out to a restaurant, and I'll go up to another table. Oh, excuse me for bothering you, sir. But what are you eating there? That looks delicious. What is that? Is that as good as it looks? Mm-hmm. And you're going to respond to me because how do you think most people respond? Total stranger going up to the table, you and your girlfriend, wife, and I'm a total stranger coming up to you, but I say your food looks so good. How do you think most people will respond?
Yeah, they're going to respond positively. Yeah, you got that once in a while jerk, but that's super rare. I got to respond.
Oh, looks so good. You're making me hungry. I'm sorry to bother you once again, but I'm going to order that. Man, you got great taste. Yeah, boom. So. I'm not coming up to you and say, hey, I see you're enjoying your meal. Would you like to talk about life insurance or getting a new mortgage policy or something? You know, that's nobody wants to invite to be sold. So that the pattern interrupt gives you a shot. And that's why it's so important to act familiar or ask a question like that.
Right. The thing I was going to say was this, and one thing I'm starting to notice, the opener that I like the most is just getting straight to the point. Hey, you got a problem. I got a solution. I can help. Being real emotional. I don't like doing this. Hey, why do I got a number in front of me? Why am I?
Okay.
Screw that.
Yeah. Do whatever you're comfortable with.
Yeah.
Experiment.
The direct approach.
Do whatever's comfortable for you. And even if you don't sell somebody, they're not interested or whatever. If you have good conversations all day long, doesn't that keep you calling and keep you working and with prospects all day? But if you get shut down, first phone call in the morning, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, take me off your list, leave me alone, go away, click, click, click. Yeah. What are you going to do the other 7 hours that day?
Exactly. The thing that I want to go over, and I know we were really limited for time. So here's what I want to do. I want to go over just pretend like you're the loan officer and pretend like I have an FHA loan, like I'm paying that FHA insurance, because there's two types of leads that we're reaching out to because we have to change our strategy. People that are paying high PMI when they don't need to be paying PMI or MIP on their FHA loan. So we can take that off because basically we're going to just switch them to a conventional, save them a bunch of money each month. And then the other type of people that we're going to be reaching out to are people that have a lot of credit card debt. So in other words, they're going to use the equity in their home, wipe out all their credit card debt, boost their score. And the whole purpose of it is, even though we can't really drop their rate extremely low, we can increase their net cash flow by about $5,000 to $1,000. Okay. So basically, in a nutshell, it's not like, hey, you want to save $2,000, $200 a month if we lower your rate. No, they actually have a pain and they don't realize they have a pain, or even if they do. In other words, we have a good reason to call them because there's some pain and we have a solution.
How much is the PMI on what's the percentage of PMI on a $100,000 loan?
Great question. So the percentage of PMI, it goes as low as 0.85%.
How much would that be on the payment then?
On a payment, you're looking at anywhere between, on $100,000, you're looking at about $150.
Okay. That's a lot of money. Okay.
Yeah. Our loan amounts, they're not $100,000. They're like $300,000 minimum and above.
Okay. So it's more than $150. It's more like $200-$300 on the PMI, no, right?
$300 minimum.
$300 minimum. The one thing I heard you say is $300 a month. I would use the bigger number, $3,600. And sir, my notes, sir, hey, Mr. Dennis, how are you? My name's Claude Diamond. My notes, my file here tells me that your five-year loan, you've paid over $18,900 in PMI insurance. Would you like to stop? Would you like to save that money instead?
Yeah, who are you?
Claude Diamond, CLA, got a pen?
Yeah, well, I'm driving right now.
Okay, don't keep your eyes on the road. I got a file in front of me, says that you've been paying $300 a month over the last 60 months for PMI insurance. That sounds to me like something like $18,000 in payments for something you don't need anymore. Would you like to save that? Would you like to save $3,600 a year?
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to save $3,600 a year. Can you just send me a quote?
I just gave it to you. I can save you.
Quote. No, can you?
I can email you a form. We can have another meeting today. When will you be home? What time?
I'll be home at 3 o'clock p.m.
You got it? Do you have an iPhone or do you like Zoom?
I have an iPhone.
I'll tell you what. I'll call you back. Let's have a face-to-face so you know who I am. And I will email you the form and you can ask me any questions you want, but we can get rid of that PMI at this point. Off the role play. Is that what you're trying to do? Get a new loan without the PMI?
Yeah, get a new loan without the PMI. And then the second part is if they have a bunch, sometimes they'll be intertwined. So they'll have PMI and a lot of debt.
Okay.
And we just use equity in their home.
Can you start using the bigger numbers? If the loan was originated in 2015, here we are, end of 2021. That's 72 months times $300. Can you use the big number? Sir, you've paid $21,200 for insurance that you don't need. I can cut $300 a month off your payment. You can use that money for so many other things. How do you feel about that, sir?
I mean, that's good, but who are you? I mean, where are you calling from?
I'm here in San Diego. I'm calling from my office. I have a file in front of me that said that you're paying, and we basically set it to find people who want to save money. You're paying way too much money. And what I can do, my company does is we're a mortgage resolution. We're a mortgage company. We find people like you and save them tens of thousands of dollars in wasted money on PMI insurance that you don't need to pay. Is that of interest to you, sir? Because we can do this and by maybe a week after Halloween, by your maybe your November or December payment, you don't have to waste another $300 a month. What would you do with an extra $300 a month?
Well, I mean, I put it towards the principal of my house because I don't have any debts.
There you go. And you have a 30-year loan. Do you know you'd knock off 7 years? That extra $300 a month would approximately knock down your loan, take 7 years off your loan, unless you want to make the bank rich.
I appreciate it.
I have one opening, sir, at 4:30 today. Can we call then and do a FaceTime thing? And when you're not driving, and I'll do the paperwork. If you want to move forward, if you want to fire me, that's okay too. I'm just here to save your money, sir.
Okay. Can you call me back in 2 weeks?
No. This is a limited program, sir. Right now, this is your opportunity, sir. I can't call you in 2 weeks. I just can't. I'm too busy and the program might be over by then.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and send me a quote.
Time is of the essence, sir. Right now. Can we meet at 4:30 or should I let you go back to your drive?
Yeah, we can, but
it's not a hard decision. I just want to save your money. I'm pretty straightforward guy. We meet at 4:30. I'll when you're not driving and everything, and you can ask me all the questions you want. If you feel good about it, great. If not, I'll leave you alone.
Okay. I mean, yeah, it's something I definitely want to do though, but I definitely want to check with my lender to see what they have to offer first.
You can check with, okay. I don't know the answer. I'm sure you have better answers than I can come up with on that. I mean, that sounds like a good objection. You know more about your business. Can the existing lender do that now or will they do that? Or
Yeah. So typically, so the way it works is most of the times a broker, not all time, but most of the times the broker is going to have better rates than the lender. So okay. Let's just say we're a broker, we'll have better rates than Wells Fargo or Bank of America, because think about it, Bank of America, Chase, Navy Federal, they have brand recognition. So the fact, even though the borrower is going to pay like 0.5% more or percent more in interest to do the loan, they have trust built with the company rather than someone calling them from, sure. You know.
But you can, once again, back to the money. If you know it's well, you know your competition, Wells Fargo, yeah. Bank of America, Chase. Say, sir, who are you with? Wells Fargo, good company, nothing wrong with them. The only thing is I can probably save you a half a point. I can save you a half a point also on your mortgage. Besides getting rid of the PMI, we can give you a half a point less than you're paying right now because we're very competitive to Wells Fargo.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? You're saving money and you're losing the PMI, $300 a month, $3,600 a year. Key off the role play. I would make it, the key is making it emotional. Money's emotional. I would keep harping on, hey, you know, that bank lets you go 60 months. You've given them $18,000, $19,000. You didn't have to. Okay. You've been paying on time and they didn't call you on it. I'm calling it today because I get things done, sir.
Gotcha. Yeah. It basically that urgency right there. Because a lot of times, a lot of people.
I have done deals on very expensive houses, my mentoring programs, company training programs, a lot of money. And the unique thing, and I've closed them in my word of honor, one phone call, because I made it so emotional. When you keep it intellectual, they start thinking, well, maybe I should call this guy or this company or that one. The more emotional you make it, the more you can get a commitment, an appointment, a contract, or a positive affirmation, right? Yeah, let's just do this, man. This sounds great. I'll see you at 4:30. Boom. That's what you want to hear.
Gotcha. But Claude, no, and I appreciate it, but I want to see what my current lender, Wells Fargo, has to offer.
I don't blame you. I would do the same thing. That's really smart. I can be much more, I can be competitive. Now, if this is the truth, I can save you a quarter to a half a point more than your existing bank, and I can get rid of the PMI. And we can probably do this by by November 15th, maybe get you. So imagine Christmas, you got that extra $300 for gifts or something like that. Okay. And you got to ask yourself, why didn't your banker ever call you and make the same phone call I'm making? Because it's not in their best interest to give you the savings.
It is. Yeah, you're right. That's why they don't contact you.
Yeah. I love the truth. You know what's great about the gut system? It's so damn honest. Even when I'm more expensive, you know, when I'm more expensive than other people, say, yes, sir, I can't save your money. We're the most expensive XYZ company in the state. Do you know why people pay us? But before I go, do you know why people pay us more money than our competition? Take a guess.
Because they're better at what you do.
Yeah, we don't bait and switch, sir. We give you a quote. We stand by it. I'm not going to come back to you and try to switch into a higher interest rate or a higher price program. I'm just going to give it to you straight up. We get it done. We get it done fast. Okay. And that's why we charge a little bit more on this program. So do you want to screw around and maybe wait a couple more months? Or would you like to get this done in the next 30 days or less?
Well, yeah, I mean, I'd like to get it done in the next 30 days or less.
I've made a decision, sir. Let's just do business. Let's meet at 4:30. Ask me anything you want, and I'll give you the quote, and I'll send you the paperwork through DocuSign, get it back to me, and I'll take care of everything else for you, and I'll give you my personal number so we can stay in communication and you know what's going on in your world. Does that make sense?
Yeah. That makes sense.
I like doing business with you, sir. Thank you. Stroke, nurture, emotional pain, and a little redirection mixed in. You wouldn't want to save money. You wouldn't want to save $3,600 a year, would you? Maybe even more with the mortgage. If we get you a better mortgage rate, it might be $5,000-$6,000 a year. I don't know if I don't know if that's important to you.
Well, of course it is.
Yeah. I remember when the competing telephone companies came out, and I had one guy do that to me. He says, I'm going to save you a lot of money and everything. I said, yeah, but My whole business is telecommunications, and your company is brand new. I don't know if it's reliable or not. Boom. He didn't have a comeback for that. All he had was savings. And sometimes I'm one of these guys. I don't always want the cheapest deal in town. I want the deal.
You want the most reliable.
Yes. Yeah. I'm in that age group where I want reliability. I don't want the cheapest. I want what works. I don't have the time to buy the cheapest products, the cheapest computer equipment, the cheapest internet system. I need reliability and good customer service. That customer service, maybe it's an age thing, but customer service means so much more to me right now than when I was in my 20s.
No, you're spot on. You're spot on. Get on the phone, even with the appraiser I'm dealing with. Dude goes like 2 weeks without contact me. Finally posted the appraiser. I'm like, and the borrower's just freaking out. Like, you know, where's the appraiser when the guy never even contacts me? But yeah, long story short, hey, I know you have to go. If you can send me a copy.
The other guy will pop in if you want to use another minute or two, just wait till the next guy pops in on it. Did you ever see, there's a section in The Office, the TV show, The Office, where they're selling paper products and they go to the guy and he says, well, the competition's cheaper than you. He said, yes, sir, they're a good company and they're cheaper than me. But when you have a problem, when you need supplies, what happens when you call them up? And he calls them right in front of them and they put them on hold with bad music. Mm-hmm. He said, now let's call my company. And they had a real girl answer the phone. Hi, Dillon Paper Company, how can I help you, sir? And they sold him right then and there just by demonstrating the way different customer service treats a company. I thought it was brilliant. It's one of the, one of the best section, best takeouts from that TV show.
Yep.
Maybe is your company big on customer? Is your company have good customer service?
That's the only way we thrive. Why don't you get on the phone?
Why don't you use that too? Okay.
Yeah, that's why I go with Quicken Loans, because even though they're not necessarily the most expensive. There's smaller companies that are more cheaper, but it's a freaking nightmare trying to do a loan with them. Quicken Loans, they got it so dialed in.
Tell that, sir. Sir, let me ask you something. Sir, you're what, 63 years old? Do you really want people who take your money and then put you on elevator music hold for 18, 19, 30 minutes? Is that what they think? Mm. That's what they think of you, sir. There's a reason why they're cheaper. I'm sorry, my company, we're a little bit more expensive, but let's call my company right now. I have another phone here. Let's call them up right now and see what happens. That's a sell. You have me into your vortex now. You've sold me. Apple Computer. I do it year after year, only because the quality of equipment and Apple Care is brilliant. I always get an English speaking person in Texas or California who solves my problem. They come online, they solve my problems so brilliantly. It's worth an extra $300 whenever I buy a computer. And I never buy extended. Well, you did Best Buy for a while. I'm one of these guys, I never buy extended warranties, never. Well, with Apple, I'll do Apple Care all day long.
Yep. Because I know probably the other guy's coming on. If he comes on, you could just go ahead and end the call. But
I wonder where he is.
Okay. Well, if you don't mind, if we could just do one little quick role play. I'm talking about just from start to finish, like from agenda, qualification, and close.
Well, we'll see if we have time. That's great.
If we have time. Yeah, if we have time, awesome. If not, just go ahead and just say, hey, you know what? We got to go. That's fine.
Oh, in fact, I did that yesterday. You got the email, right, with the recording? You should have.
I believe I did. No, I believe I did, yeah.
Fast forward it. I think it's about 20 minutes into the whole 1 hour thing. And somebody came up and said, Claude, what do you do when someone's calling up picking your brain? And we went through the entire agenda. Okay. We went through the whole thing, and then I broke down why I use these words, what's the psychological technique I use. I broke it all down. It took 40 minutes, by the way. I mean, I'm going to take it out today and put it in and send it out to everybody again, I think. But it was in the whole role play that I sent you yesterday. Go ahead. Yeah, give me a situation.
Okay, so same thing, FHA. So you're the sales rep and I'm the borrower. And so basically, we're just going to go through it like an entire calls from agenda qualification and close.
Yeah. Ring, ring.
Yeah, hello?
Yeah, hey, Mr. Dennis, this is Claude Diamond. My file says there that you're wasting about 3600, that you're overpaying $3,600 a year. Reason I'm calling is I think I can save you some money today if you're interested.
Okay, I mean, sure. But who are you calling from?
I'm actually calling from my kitchen table here right now, and I'm following up on the file I have. I'm with ABC Mortgage Company, and what we do is we find people who are overpaying thousands, tens of thousands of dollars, like yourself, and get them a better loan, save them a monthly payment, lower their monthly payment, and we get them out of the PMI $300 a month, like you're paying. I don't know if that's of interest to you.
Yeah, I mean,
I could
yeah,
save
because
you a
I'm.
lot of money. I could save you a lot of money. Your first name's Assad?
Yeah, my first name's
Yeah,
Assad.
mine's Claude. Nice to meet you, sir.
Okay, yeah, what you got?
Yeah, okay to ask you a few quick questions and then you ask me a few. And if we can do business, great. If not, you can tell me to get lost. And it was a pleasure to meet
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
you. Agenda.
Okay, agenda, I got that.
Boom. Now, qualification. Sir, a quick question. You're Mr. Dennis. You got the mortgage in 2015. I think it says here, it looks like it's 5.5% with a $312 a month PMI. Is that correct, sir?
That is correct.
Okay. Yeah, a lot of, oh man, I can save you a lot of money right now. Interest rates have gone down. And the fact that you've been paying on time and your credit rating is much stronger and you have enough equity in the home because all properties in your area have gone up. You don't need that PMI anymore. Who's your loan with originally? I think it's what was it Wells? It says here Wells
Wells
Fargo.
Fargo.
Yeah. Well,
That is correct.
they haven't called you or sent you anything for a better rate yet.
No,
Oh
not
my
at all.
gosh. You know, over the last 6 years that what you've been paying, just the PMI, 60 months times three times. $300 a month, $312. That's close to $19,432, my calculator says. That's a lot. That's
Yeah.
money you, that's, I mean, what could you do with an extra 20,000, right?
Yeah, I could do a lot.
Yeah,
Yeah.
exactly. Let me ask you this, sir. Are you the only person on the loan, or is there a Mrs. Dennis?
It's a Mrs. Dennis, yeah.
Okay. Would there be any issue with her wanting to save all thousands, tens of thousands of dollars on a new mortgage?
No, I mean there's no issue. I mean, obviously you're calling out of the blue, so she would just need to, as long as she's approved, as long as you're a reputable
We're very
person
reputable,
in.
sir. We have a Moody's a AAA rating. We're rated by Dun and Bradstreet. I'd be glad for you to send you our credentials and everything with the offer I'd like to make to you today. Is that all right?
Okay, yeah, that's fine.
You see how I off the role play? This is the second step qualification. Okay, you're the decision maker. We got the house. We know the mortgage. I think you have that information in front of you. And you challenged my credibility. And I said, good for you. I always reward people who challenge my, gee, how do I know you? We just got on the phone. You called me out of the blue. Good for you, sir. Why don't you check us out? I'll send you my credentials, my referrals, and I'll also send you an offer. Boom. Now I got your permission to send you an offer.
Right, a quote,
Okay.
basically.
Yeah. Time frame is now. You have the authority. You can, you're the decision maker. We're saving you money. And a character seemed like a nice guy on the phone. Boom. I need a little bit more of a commitment from you. Now we go to the third step, commitment to close. Assad, let me do this for you. I'm going to put together the paperwork right now with a summary statement showing you all the money you save on a lower mortgage and on getting rid of that PMI. And why don't we have a meeting this evening at 4:30? On Zoom or your iPhone, you can ask me any questions. And if you want to go ahead, I'll st you sign it through DocuSign, get it back to me. I'll process the loan, and once we get approval, which should be sometime today is Tuesday, I could possibly have approval. When? How long does it take for approval for you?
It only takes about just to get conditionally approved. It's Oh, to do the loan to get the approval? Oh, yeah, we're talking about
just preliminary approval.
Oh, you're looking at just about 1 hour.
Oh, okay. Tell you what, sir, we'll talk. If you want me to go ahead, sign the paperwork, get it back to me. I'll submit it to my boss tomorrow. I'll ask a favor and ask him to expedite it. I'll have an approval for you by tomorrow afternoon, and then we can facilitate this and save you thousands of dollars. Are you comfortable with that decision, sir?
Yes, I'm comfortable with the decision.
I appreciate your trust. Thank you.
Got it.
I'll talk to you and your wife at 4:30 and ask me anything you want. Meanwhile, I'll send you my credentials and I'll send you a blank application form.
Got it.
Boom. Got a commitment, got an appointment, got the paperwork going, one phone call. None of this. Let's get together. I'll call you next Friday. That's bullshit. You got to go for it. Well, sometimes you got to kiss the girl at the doorstep, like I always say. You know, just go for it.
Nice. Yep.
I do exactly those three steps. You know, and guts is a question-based system where I'm stroking, I'm nurturing, I'm trying to make it emotional. I'm using redirection. I'm using pattern interrupts at the very beginning, so important. And I'm trying to find some need or greed that makes sense to you right at the beginning. Yes. And so I can get
it. Yeah, right there. Because a lot of people get to the point, what's this about? And you hit them with it. It's like using a direct approach on a woman. Don't, you know, none of this, you know, oh, you know, I like your head. And, you know, you have this wonderful energy. F that, man. Get to the point, man. Just tell you why you're there. Here's what I can do from you. Find that pain point. Oh man, my confidence in the last few days, I'm not gonna lie, it felt real, I was real uncomfortable doing it because it's just so unconventional, but I just say, you know what, screw it. Just, hey, here's your problem. This is what I got. I can help you and your family. Can we do business today if we can solve your problem?
Yeah. Bam. What's the worst they could do to you? Hang up?
Yeah.
What's the worst that could happen? Sales is dangerous. It's dangerous because we have a chance of getting our tender little feelings hurt in this little woke world, okay? And so while everybody else is crying about all this little bullshit in the world, you are making money because you have the guts to talk to people straight up. You're helping people, aren't you? You're saving them money.
Yep.
Is that anything to be ashamed about if you make a reasonable, honest commission by helping people save them money? Do you have any guilt about that?
No guilt. The only thing I was just running into was, well, can I just, you know, check with my lender? Can I just, you know, shop around first? That was just like the biggest thing. Just getting them to make a decision today. Yeah. And because I'm a stranger calling them, it's just a little hesitancy.
You've got to sound familiar. That's why I like my favorite. Sorry, it took me so long to get back to you. Sir, I've got your file in front of me. I was outraged when I looked at this, sir. You have overpaid with this PMI. Nobody's called you about the PMI. You've spent over $18,000 on insurance you don't need, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I mean, I have that, but how'd you get my information? And typically a good rebuttal.
It's a great question. Be honest. You know, it's a great question, sir. My company specializes in finding people like yourself, people who have equity in their home, who've maintained their payments, who deserve to save money. And we go out and search. We use different systems to search for people and homes like you have, sir, and save people money. We are very successful at what we do because we give people value when nobody else is willing to do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, are you going to actually do that?
What's that?
Yeah. I mean, I'm interested. Yeah. I think you've already hit all the bases right there. So, and I know you have to go. So let me do this. Before I do go, our team is really struggling right now. It's almost all loan officers are struggling right now, and we're looking for a new training system. It's the way it works is we have callers in the Philippines that call and transfer the calls to us, and then the loan officers try to close them. Is it okay if I use this, if I share this video with my, with our loan officers? Because right now.
No, go right ahead. In fact, if you want to schedule a group, a special 30-minute group training session on me, my gift to you, that'd be fine.
My broker has paid thousands and tens of thousands of dollars for leads that didn't. He spent like $50,000 for a freaking guy that spent $30,000 on Facebook. So it cost him like close to $50,000, produces zero. He spent almost well over $100,000 in the last 2 years on courses and trainings that didn't, on mainly just to get leads that didn't do squat. We have a good lead source. That's good. But we just don't have like a good sales system. And that's what's missing. We got good quality leads, but our sales, we're not hitting those emotional pain points.
See, nobody wants to talk about the art and science of persuasion. I call it the million-dollar skill for a reason. It changed my life. Honestly, I had a lot of trouble with sales. I was kind of a scripted blah, blah, blah. Let me show you my PowerPoint thing. And people gave me the rejection, the stalls, the objections all day long because I was just another Kleenex out of the box. Okay. Mm-hmm. You've got to make you ever meet people and they make an impact on you socially or business? Right away, you say, man, I like what this dude has to say. I like this person. He's got a great idea there. You've got to be the bull in the china shop, you know, a little bit, even if it's not in your nature. You flip that switch and you go right for it and you kill them with the honesty.
Yes, I like that honesty. It's a lot easier to talk to people when you're dishonest because you're not thinking about, let me just, you know, step around. It's hard to lie when you're honest.
Asad, I want to think about it and shop around for a little while. You're a great guy. Thanks for all the information.
Hey, Claude, I greatly appreciate it though, but here's the truth though. Claude, you're not allowed to think about it.
I love that. See, what balls? You got to have gigantic elephant balls to say that line.
Right. Yeah, Claude, you're not allowed to think about it. When people say you're not, or when people say that, you know, that they need to think about it, and it's okay to say no, they're just having a hard time saying no. Claude, is this something you really want, or is it just, you're just having a hard time saying no to me?
What I usually do is I'm freezing up a lot, but I know you can still hear me. What I do is I then apologize. See, that's a shock and awe technique. You're not allowed to think about it. You have, and there's a pregnant pause. And this guy's going, "Hey, wait! Did this guy just kick me in the groin? What is? Who are you to tell me I can't think about it? You know?" And it's almost a pattern. It's like a red flag in front of the bull to get an emotional reaction. Sir, let me apologize. I think you're being a little bit too polite to me. When people tell me that, that means I'm fired. So why don't we just say it's over right now? But you'd be making, you know what the trouble is, sir? Sir? Oh, you froze.
Yeah. Okay. I'm here. Yeah. Okay. What's the trouble?
The trouble is you're going to get off this phone and have a lot of regrets because I was the one guy who could save you a ton of money. And while you're thinking about it and shopping and maybe forgetting me, I could have had that paperwork done for you and I can get an approval by tomorrow. I can facilitate the paperwork. And in 15 to 20 days from now, if we can get an appraiser there, they're very busy right now. If we can get an appraiser over to your property, we can save you the PMI and maybe save you a quarter to three quarters of a point in your mortgage payment. Are you in the mood to save a lot of money?
Well, I'm in the mood to save a lot of money.
Sir, I make a lot of money. I'm the best in my business. Do you know why?
Why?
Because I save people a lot of money. I don't fool around. We get right to work here. Even if you didn't like our quote and you didn't like me saving you $3,600 a year, you could still fire me if you want. Does that make sense?
No, that makes sense. Claude, I appreciate your call. I got everything. I just don't, I mean, we've only spoken. I love everything you're telling me. It makes sense. I want to see the quote. It's just that making the decision today, I mean, this is my mortgage.
And Asad, I have to go. I have Miss Lipinski online here. She's right on time. Okay. Everything. Good session, man.
If you,
oh, she left.
Okay, good. Hey, if,
where did she go?
Oh, don't worry, she'll be back. Don't worry. So let's do this. If you could save this recording and then send it to me, so that way we can do it, because.